Hi all, in this video I'm going to share guys a complete walkthrough to use lens blur in DaVinci Resolve. You can add the lens blur option from the color tab, fusion tab or the edit tab. Whichever you use, the function is same, that is the function of lens blur is same, so you don't need to worry about watching this video and this video is getting uses, so you don't need to worry about that. So for this guide I'm going to use a clip which got only a single light source, so you can easily get the idea of all the function of all the sliders on this lens blur effects. So add the lens blur on the clip that you want to add the lens blur, and on the shape type there is three options. First one is the real aperture. These are the shape that is on par with our lens aperture shape. So you can find all the shape like triangle, hexagon, pentagon, like all that sort of things which is similar to our lens. And the second one is the creative type, that is this is some creative shapes like earth, like petals, like all that sort of shape, and it's going to give you a creative look on the blur you add to the clip. And the third option is the external option, and by using this option you can create your own custom shape and you can use that shape for the blur, so you can get your own blur. And the thing to notice that to use the external option you need to use this lens blur option from the fusion tab. If you use it from edit tab or color page you can't use that, so you need to use it on fusion tab. And these are all the lens blur you will get by using all these options. And if you use the preview shape option, you can see the shape that you choose, and it will help you to change the other values on the lens blur option very efficiently. So you can use that or not, it's up to you. And next is the speed option. Simply, speed means the quality of the shape of the blur. And there is three options, full, half and quarter. And by changing this value, the quality of the shape will differ. And if you use external shape option, then there will be option for cropping the shape. So you can use that to crop the shape if the shape become very big or something like that. And next option is the blur size. Simply it means the amount of blur, and in depth it means the size of the shape. If you increase the blur size, then the shape will also increase in size, and depending on your footage you can use the different value for getting a nice bokeh type effect. Next is the blade curvature option. It manages the shape of the aperture shape that you use. If you increase the value, your aperture shape will change shape to become circle, and if you decrease the value, you will get more concrete aperture shape. Next is the rotation. It will help to rotate the shape you are using as your aperture shape. And next is the anamorphism. It is stretches your shape. If you increase the value, it is stretches your shape, and if you decrease the value, it contracts your shape. And chroma shift means it add chromatic aberration to the shape. Basically, it add red, blue, green color to the shape, that is to adjust the shape. Next is the highlight. If you enable the preview shape option, you can't change this value. So just disable that and you can change the value. Simply this highlight option changes the brightness value of blur. Increasing will increase the brightness value. Decreasing will decrease the brightness value. Next is the apodization. Simply soften the edges of the shape. So if you increase the value, it softens the edges. While decreasing the value, it is often the edges but in inside out fashion. So it's going to change the shape into an oval shape. Next is the catadioptric option. Increasing this value will create a cutout inside the shape to create an oval effect. And lastly, there is global blend option, which simply is the opacity. So increase the value and decrease the value. It's going to change the opacity of the lens blur you added to the clip. So that's all about this in-depth walkthrough guide to use lens blur in DaVinci Resolve. I hope you guys find this video useful. If you do so, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe.